Well, hello and welcome to Edison Light Globes. I'm Phil Greenwood, and today what we're going to do is we're going to discuss E27 lamp holders. Now, an E27 lamp holder is obviously a screw fitting. It's an Edison screw. That's E for Edison. And the 27 is the diameter of that thread. So if we look at this thread here, we should have, what does that say, Louis? We should end up with
26.8.
Oh, hang on. 26.8? Yeah, 27. So 27 mil. So the 27 in E27 is the diameter of the screw thread. That is the Edison designed, invented thread type. So, for every other country apart from North America, Japan, E27 is a standard 220 to 240 volt component. Now, our lamp holders are basically, these ones are all brass. We're going to concentrate on brass for the moment. There's a solid brass, heavy duty, high performing lamp holder for critical applications where you need a longevity. So we've got ceramic components, brass components, and a thread made of plastic, and that will last a lot longer than a lot of other components. So what we thought we might do is to explain how these wire up, how they are protected from coming undone once you've wired them up, and also how to use the cord grip part on what is a pendant type. So we're going to do that soon. The other thing we have with these lamp holders is they are available in different types. We have a 10 mil threaded entry for fixed type situation, a 1/2 inch brass thread entry. There's a special 20 mil entry, which is a conduit thread. And we also have a batten holder, which is large enough to take mains cable directly into the connection. So this will directly fix to a surface and be the same lamp holder top, essentially this part. So they're the different types of lamp holders that we supply. The E27 brass pendant lamp holder is the one that we're going to explain now exactly how to wire this and why we do it a certain way. So the lamp holder comes basically sort of just packed together upside down. What we're going to do first is just disassemble the parts. So the first part is the cord grip sort of screw clamp, then the cord grip plastic component, the top of the lamp holder, the connector in ceramic, and this is a 3-pin connector, so it's active, earth, and neutral, and then the body of the lamp holder. So the first thing to do probably is to get some cable. This is a one of our decorative regular 3-core double insulated twisted braided 240 volt cables. So the first thing we want to do is put the cord grip clamp component on, and then we're going to put the pointy end of the cord grip plastic components on. We're not going to do anything to them yet. We're then going to put in the cap of the lamp holder. Now we can strip and connect our connector. So the first thing with the braided cable is not to get it too unwound. So we're just going to release a little bit of the winding on the cable. We're going to pull back the cloth braid to expose the cable. And in this case, the green, yellow is the earth, and this is the first one we're going to strip. So we use these Weed Mueller strippers, which just make things a lot quicker for us in production, but you can do this with pliers, but this is a lot more accurate and it won't wreck the cable as you go. You'll see this unstrip as we go. Hopefully we're in focus. It's a bit rough, that one. Anyway, so we've stripped the cable. And this, it's not ideal, but this is double insulated. So what we do is we just twist that up We can then, I've got very long fingernails, excuse those, but that enables me to turn that over. So we get a little bit of a wider thickness of cable. And then if you can see that, insert, let go of the braid and tighten that up. So just to explain, this center back terminal connects to this earth tab, which makes connection to the body of the lamp holder to maintain a ground or an earth. Now the next is the active cable, which is brown. Now the active cable needs to go to the active pin, which is this one, and this one corresponds to the center pin on the globe. So the way the globe works, we have a center pin here and a thread here. This is two parts of the circuit for the globe. This is the active. The reason why we use the center pin as the active is because the outer connection inside the lamp holder, which connects to the thread, being neutral, if we connected it to active, as you unscrew the globe, you can touch the thread. So the idea is you make sure that the active terminal is the protected center pin. Now, strip those. This stripper doesn't feel great, but it's all right. Again, we'll just twist that, turn it over, insert that. Can you see that? Insert that in. I'm trying to do this backwards. Do that tight. Make sure you don't poke the thing into your fingers. I hate this one. Screwdriver. Now, blue, neutral. Again, strip the cable, twist, turn it over, and then sometimes I actually like to retwist the braid just to make sure that that doesn't come undone. So hold that in, again, carefully tighten that, and then going to have a look at what we've got. So we're just going to tidy up this. What is this end here? So what we'll do now is we'll just have a look at this braided cable, just pushed, just held, and just cleaned up a little bit so this braid is nice and tight. And you'll notice that the earth terminal is a little bit closer to the length of the cable than the active and neutral. And what this does is creates a little bit of a loop in the earth. Now that's actually a safety feature. And what that means is if for any reason this cable becomes under stress and it's pulled, and you may pull out cable connections, it makes sure that the very last cable to come loose is the ground or earth. So if, even if there's a stray active and it comes into contact with the body of the lamp holder, making the lamp holder live, that would short to earth straight away. If any problems associated with this wiring, the earth should be the last connection to be destroyed. So that's why there's that little loop. And we're going to sort of try and accommodate that into the cap. So we tend to just keep that pressured in. Now, we're going to connect this or push this into the cap. You'll notice there's a little tab that corresponds to the earth tab, which is coming from the earth wiring. And that basically is under pressure, so that needs to be pushed in. I can just try to get that in without doing too much. There you go. So we've got a lined up tab there, and the earth tab lined up with this little indentation, and we end up with that now secure, locked in. Now we have the cable hopefully still twisted and braided at this cord grip end. I'm just going to grab what is the plastic part. Now what we do next is we will insert the cord grip plastic compression components, make sure they're in at the square end, into the square hole in the top of the lamp holder. Make sure they're in as hard as you can. Hold them in with your other hand and then grab the compression nut. Make sure that you push and turn in a clockwise direction. Ooh, and I do that up right-handed. Now this can be initially a little bit difficult, but eventually when you tighten that up, you'll see the compression components there coming together and squeezing into the taper and grabbing the cable. And that's just finger tight, that should be fine. Now the next part is just the main body with the thread component in there. That's the plastic thread component, which will come out if you need to. And we put this on very carefully. This is a very large thin thread, so it does take a little bit of accuracy to make sure this is not going on crooked and you don't cross thread it. And it's a little bit tricky. So once you start to feel it going easily, then you're right. And you'll hear, if you can hear it, you hear there's a slight ratchet as it goes up. And what that's doing is, I can't see if I can show it to you, inside here there is a little tab that is a ratchet, and it's actually, I'll show you here, it's actually this component, which is going one way, but won't allow the body of the lamp holder to rotate back the other way. So it's actually locking it. Now, if you end up in the situation where you've made a mistake, the cable's too long, the cable's the wrong color, and you want to try and remove everything, you won't be able to undo this barrel again because it's locked with that ratchet. So if you do need to undo it, you need to find that little ratchet, and I think it's, is it here, Libby?
First camera.
I can't see, hang on. You can reach in, peel that ratchet back inside, just bend it back out of the way, and then everything will undo. You will need to push that ratchet, that little bent piece of steel, you will need to bend that back again when you do it up. But subsequently, we've got a fixed, now, locked on lamp holder that can't get pulled out. We've got, on this one, one shade ring. If we need, we've got a gallery that will attach to attach what are glass shades or metal shades that have a gallery top. This is a 2¼ gallery. I'll just quickly put it on, but anyway, with another shade ring, that shade ring will do up tight and it will give us an ability to put a shade on rather than just have a bare bulb. But what I'll do, I'll take that off actually. Yeah. So that's, there we have it. We've got a finished lamp holder which will take our E27 globe, and we've got a little Edison in there. We would normally have a shade on that component, but we don't. Okay, so there you have it. This is the finished result. An E27 brass lamp holder pendant, all finished, ready to be installed. If there's any questions, let us know. We will be doing a video soon for bayonet lamp holders and B22 bayonet, generally used maybe in the UK. I'm trying to think, UK, New Zealand, Queensland, wherever things are a little bit old-fashioned and a bit backward. no, I'm only kidding. Tends to be most of Europe is E27 or Edison screw. Edison screw is used everywhere else, but we do get occasionally asked questions for bayonet lamp holders. They're very different to wire. There's different things that you need to do. So that'll be in a subsequent video. So for now, I hope you enjoyed that, and if there's any questions, let us know. Subscribe if you like the video. If there's any other lamp holders you want us to explain, we have ceramic, Bakelite, E40. There's a whole lot of different types of lamp holders we do. We might even do, if I can do it, E26 American style sockets, not lamp holders. We've got a word for everything. We'll attempt to go through our version of those 120 volt sockets for North American customers, but that'll be in another video. Anyway, for now, thanks for watching and subscribe if you like the video. Bye.